So to create your own guild, you're gonna need over 2 million rolls, and then you're also gonna need over 800k rolls to be able to trade in a guild. So the way trading works, you can only trade items between players. You can't trade cards. There's no card trading. So for example, if you go over to your backpack, anything you see in your backpack, you're gonna be able to trade to another player. Honestly, they don't even need to put anything up. So it's like a gifting system, not really trading. But I guess you could also trade with them as well. So we're gonna look over at the guild home tab. You'll notice that my guild level is level 2. My guild XP is 125 out of 200. And there's a guild season over here. So currently the guild season, it doesn't really mean anything at the moment. All it really means is that at the end of the time, your boss is gonna reset and it's gonna be rotated to a new boss that's either a raid or just a boss in the game. So every time you level up your guild XP threshold is going to increase as well. So my guild's level 2 now. It went from 0 out of 100 to 0 out of 200. So I'm assuming level 3 is probably either 0 out of 300 or 0 out of 400. So every time you level up your guild, it's going to increase. As you level up your guild as well, your member cap to your guild is going to increase by plus 1. When you first start off your guild, you're going to have 15 slots available. But as you upgrade your guild, you're going to get plus 1 slot every level. No matter what level, it's always plus 1. I made some suggestions to try to fix that or increase it a bit because I just felt it kind of weird that, let's say for example, you reach guild level 5 and you're still getting the same plus 1 memory cap. So now we're gonna look at the quest tab here. So there's daily quests. My daily quests haven't really changed that often, but each quest gives you plus 1 XP and they're relatively easy to beat. So reached infinite floor 100. When I already have my infinite floors on, it just automatically counts it, and then I don't have to reach 100 floors. And then use 5 potions, just use any 5 potions, roll card, and then beat lobby obby. So for people who are confused, for the beat lobby obby one, you can't use auto kunai stop or whatever in the setting. You have to manually pick it up. So now that we're looking at the weekly quest, there's also a weekly section here. This has 4 quests as well. You can do 4 of them as well. These are harder to do than the regular daily ones, but they also contribute towards guild XP for your guild and they reset weekly. Next thing to look at is the boss. So the boss is pretty much based on the amount of damage that the whole guild can contribute together to beat it. So the max cap is a pretty high threshold, but there's ways to beat it. I know Z-God created a video on how to beat it pretty easily if you have a cheap deck, but I'm just going to show you guys how you do it. So my Wandering Samurai's ability does work on Flicker God for some reason. So this is one of the ways to beat it, but obviously not everybody has this team. This is just my team, but yeah. So obviously, like normal, after a certain amount of time, your card's going to lose its ability, so you don't go into an infinite loop. But you'll notice here that the damage went up a little bit. The left side is the damage we've already dealt, and then the right side is the damage threshold that you need to meet to complete the boss. For us, it didn't give us a reward, but you're supposed to get a reward at the bottom of the progress bar that says claim, and then you can claim like potions and stuff like that. So at the moment, there's no way to track each individual contribution to the guild. So what I have is in my Discord, I set up a section called Guilds. So there's 3 channels I have. One's called Guild Daily. So each person has a role called Wizard 101, and only they have access to that role because they're part of my guild. But as you'll see, I have a channel called Guild Daily, and then I have them post their images of their dailies here, and then I check mark it. And then once I'm done checking marking it, I go to name tracker, and then I just put one just to keep track that they put it. And then each day I delete that one and then post it again. But we also have a guild chat and then guild announcements and stuff like that. Hopefully they implement this in the game itself, so we don't have to be doing this in Discord, because I know not everybody has access to Discord. So next thing we check out is the admin section. This is mainly for like leaders and admins. Leaders and admins can invite and kick people to the guild, but you need to be in the same exact server to be able to do this. So I would recommend just inviting someone to your private server, having them pop up on the right side, and then invite them to the guild. Now the same thing also works for trading. They also need to be in your same private server to be able to trade with them. So that pretty much covers everything about guilds in game. Today should be an update, so maybe they add more to it, but right now it's not much else to do, but this covers everything. Now I'm going to show you guys how you can upload your own image like I have in my guild with Wizard 101 as well. Just remember that your file size can only be max of 20 MB, so just keep that in mind while we do this. Since I already created my guild, I don't have access to this and I don't have an alt account, so we're going to go by the image. First things first, you're going to need a guild token. How do you get a guild token? You have a 10% chance of getting it from any fight you do. I got it pretty much instantly when new update started from doing Hardcore Infinite with a speedrun team. I got it really quick. Next thing you're going to see at the bottom right is the image of a smiley face or whatever that is. I don't know. You're going to see a code right above it. That's going to be the asset ID we're going to want to copy from Roblox in a little bit. And then on the bottom, you're gonna see the best guild. You're gonna be able to create your guild name in that slot where the best guild is, and it's a unique name. So there can only be one of that name, and no one's gonna be able to copy it. So you're gonna wanna create this as fast as you can. I will start things first. We're on a Roblox page now. We're gonna wanna click Create. On the left side, we're gonna wanna click Creations. And then on the right side, where it says Development Items, we're gonna wanna click that and go over to Decals on the bottom right here. In decals, you're going to want to upload an asset. It has to be a JPG, a PNG, a TGA, or a BMG file. For me, I just use my logo for my YouTube, so it's relatively easy. So you just want to do that. You want to click upload asset, and then once your upload asset is done, you're going to see your asset on the bottom right here. So this is the upload asset page. You can give it whatever name you want. Or whatever, you just want to make sure that you have your right image that you want for your guild. Next thing is you're going to notice three dots when you go over to your image on the bottom. So I'm hovering over my image called a wizard. You'll notice three dots here. You're going to want to click copy asset ID. So when you copy asset ID, you're going to want to go to over to the Roblox game. And since I don't have it up anymore because I have a guild, you're going to want to go over to the image section right here where it says the code, and you're going to want to post in your copy asset ID and then copy and paste it in, and then your image is going to pop up in your guild. So if I went over to in game, you're going to see that my image is the wizard logo, and then my guild name is Wizard 101. So if any of you guys found this video helpful in any way, whether it was uploading an image or just figuring out how you can create your own guild or just anything, let me know down below in the comments if I missed anything. But don't forget to join the Discord, guys. We host nukes in the Discord, and I'm also accepting members to join my guild in my Discord in the apply for my guild section.